I'm digging this Vici Gaming's lineup.
A first time for him.
Tournament, yes.
I think this is going to be the hardest, the hardest game for Secret based on draft.
Lineup-wise, it's actually... They don't have a very super strong character. I mean, Bristleback would...
It's black on co-op, unless they swap. But it might just be a mind game here.
Does it mean black would go safe lane and they would actually rotate supports very quick? I mean, that would be an option, yeah? I put black on safe lane.
I want to point out, Artesis heroes in 683. Lycan 6 times, Shadowfiend 9 times, Tide 2 times, Razor 1 time.
Bristle 1 time.
Now Bristle 1 time.
So, before we pass it over to the casters, just want to mention how difficult it's going to be for Rubick Chen. So the reason Bounty Hunter is really good is when he can run after Chen, he will often struggle if the secondary support is one that can shut him down. Like, yeah, off the top of my head, a hero that's never picked right now, but something like a Venomancer or a Shadow Demon, Skywrath Mage. Yeah. But Rubick has nothing on level 1. So this Bounty Hunter will probably have free access. They can't stop him at all in the beginning.
Just a very good bounty game to pick.
It's great. Great pick for Vici Gaming to see the opening. This game is going to be amazing.
Yes.
Who'd you favor?
I think Vici's lineup is a little bit better. Secret, it's just what they've been going for the entire time.
They
a little bit different for, I guess,
exploited their weakness.
Yeah. Winter, what do we have to look out for in this game?
Just the main thing for Vici is how successful the Bounty Hunter will be. I just imagine the Bounty will just get a lot done. So that's about it.
Excellent. Having said that, we're going to go to the casters. Lumi, LD, this is all yours. Take it away.
All right, guys, welcome into Game 2. Vici Gaming leading this best of 3, 1-0, and already, FY, with that Iron Shell, classic pub tactics for your Bounty Hunter Darkseer duo, getting things done. They'll drop down their first ward here, looking to block that medium camp. We want to introduce the teams, but first, got to make sure nobody dies.
Let's be real. If this was a pub game, nobody left the base yet. Still buying their items in the fountain.
Still raging that you have this Bounty Hunter pick.
Where's my chicken?
So, Lumi, the first thing I want to do when we introduce these teams is it's actually something different. Super is the one on the Lycan.
Yep.
It normally is not a superhero by any stretch, and it will, in fact, be Black playing the Queen of Pain. You know, you look back to some of his old teams, like Mouse Sports, he was never really allowed by the team to play anything except for kind of standard hard carries. But Vici Gaming have time and again allowed Black to test his hand at something different.
Well, somebody got to lift that team, right? Because it was Bamboo and Sing Sing. And it was, like, really heavy.
Well, even the later incarnations of Mouse Sports as well. But this is definitely something different. So with that, we'll run through Team Vici Gaming. FY on that Bounty Hunter support, looking to harass the Chen. Ice playing your off-lane Darkseer. Super, going to be on the solo mid Lycanthrope. It's Black playing the Queen of Pain safe lane. And it leaves Fenrir on the support Lion.
Yeah, so I guess before we introduce the Secret team, one thing I do want to just get out there, get off my chest, is that I feel that when you play Bounty support, one of the biggest weaknesses of this hero is that he doesn't do anything when there's a 5-man push coming your way. Yeah, sure, you could track people and give vision to your team, but when there's Chen creeps on your tower and there's like Puck threatening to coy you and there's like a Bristleback beating on your T1 and T2s, you don't want a Bounty Hunter there. So I think Vici's early game has to go extremely well, because if it comes down to Vici defending
Fenrir,
pushes,
this could be our first blood.
Oh,
he's getting pursued out. The Spin Lord is real with Zai.
Oh, he needs to reproc a... Juke to the south?
Juke.
Okay,
Black, don't block him. Don't
he
block him.
Fine.
That's close, though. Yeah. But yeah, let's introduce Secret. You've got Arteezy going mid as your Bristleback, and the offlane will be Zai, cutting the wave as the Axe. And supporting him will be Puppy, who's tried to go offensive jungle. It's hard to get in here. He's going to be playing your Chen. They might actually make a go now on Zai with the Orb of Venom Slow. This could be enough to get the kill. Zai spinning, but not winning just yet. Everybody kiting him beautifully. They'll get the kill. So rounding out our Secret introductions, we've got Kuroki playing that safe lane support Rubick, and it leaves S4 on the puck. And Lumi, this Darkseer is just styling all over Secret, running down two heroes simultaneously. Creep chasing after Kuroki with Ion Shell, and S4 really struggling. Here. He's not getting a ton of CS, but he is really chewing through the regen.
Yeah, the reason that Chen is playing the way he is, as Chen actually got the rune, is because there is a threat of a Bounty Hunter, right? You could be jungling, but you can't play it like last game because your experience will get cut in half. FY is going to get a couple of lasts as a result. That kill also was absolutely huge for FY because it propels him to that level 2. When you have the Orb of Venom and your Janata slow, you could actually just kill people.
You can just man up a Puppy. Even with a Ched creep, it's still going to be fairly difficult. He's got 6 armor.
Yep.
And he's going to be here following Puppy around. He's running a bit low on mana, though. So we may see FY have to make a pit stop back to the base fairly soon. Puppy's like, oh, hello. This is not what I was hoping to see. No. He tried to dodge away from the bounty hunter.
FY is the one that's saying hello.
The big thing, like, he goes into the Radiant Jungle. Part of that is that his jungle was warded off. But the other part is just he really wants to just dodge FY as much as possible. But FY's just been one step ahead of Puppy, or at least close behind him, if nothing else. And as a result, Puppy's chat at this stage of the game, often level 3, level 4, if he's having a good time. He's level 1. And yeah, bounty hunter is also level 1, but if you'd rather have the Chen being level 4 if you're Team Secret, even if that means the bounty hunter is more level.
Oh, he might actually die here, and in fact, he will. That
but
last
bounty hunter's coming. He's got howl damage as well. He's got the Orb of Venom. He's swinging the wrong direction, though. The Secret heading back to the woods. Oh, he wants to buy a TP scroll, it looks like.
I thought he would have gone for the
I thought he could have gone for the
Kuro.
Rubick there. The lift was on cooldown. He has the Orb of Venom slow, but actually Kuro does have the boots, so not really a possible kill, as it turns out.
Yeah, one thing small to point out was that the courier never actually left the base until 3 minutes, and they upgraded immediately, because against a bounty hunter, you got to do that, or your courier's just going to get sniped.
They're hoping that they jump on Ice here. If they do...
Oh, is Super going to die here on the mid lane? Solo kill by Arteezy.
Ice going in top. Meanwhile, they're trying to engage onto Kuroki, bringing him low. Ice may fall here again. The Iron Shell will burn down one. Now backing off for Puppy. Can FY get this kill too?
Oh,
support
solid.
Bounty Hunter getting out of control. He'll get another kill. 3-3 your score. But getting the Lycan kill mid, that is gigantic for Team Secret. I think far bigger than any of these other kills so far.
Rule number one, never lose mid without getting a gank. That's what Blitz has told me. As a 7k caster. And apparently...
Well, I mean, I'll believe what he said because that's, you know, not common sense or anything. Since he's 7k. It's not going to get caught out here. VG will jump in bottom lane trying to finish off the axe. They kite him pretty well. They get the kill. It cost them their support Lion, but taking down that offlaner and mid lane now abandoned as Super goes to the jungle. Your Bristleback going to start pressuring Black, and this is not really something that Black can easily lane against. Already 1,300 gold out on Arteezy.
Yeah, I mean, unfortunately, Bristleback's not one of those heroes that you get an early goal lead, and then you just, like, snowball, right?
Top lane, more engagements coming out. They hex up S4. Do they actually chase
it? Different heroes, though, so...
Yeah, a little bit uncoordinated from VG Gaming.
Yeah. But this is kind of what you want from a kind of offlane Darkseer, right? You don't necessarily expect a ton of farm, although he is getting a decent amount. Black, gotta blink away. He has it available. You know, everybody was saying, can Arteezy actually play this hero? He's playing it very well.
He is. He's a very versatile player. Anyone who says Arteezy can only play a few heroes do not see him in NEL. I mean, he can play the tempo controllers too. His puck is magnificent, but they just feel like he's the most solid one position player on the team. So you have S4, you have Zai. Frankly, all three of these to me are fairly interchangeable and probably could play any of the roles if need be. They're a very versatile squad. And we'll have a pause here from
Kala.
Super.
Is that what's happening?
Kala?
Kala.
A quick Kala. Very quick. But Puppy's still level 2. To me, that's the big thing to keep an eye on for Secret, is this is just a very underfarmed Shen. He's sitting behind Zai for now. The stomp comes out well placed by Puppy, and Super thinks about going for it. He's going to bait out the call. Now he can kill Puppy. Nicely done. He munches him down. Does he even go back for Zai? I don't think you want to go on this axe with Tranquil Boots.
Oh my god.
Watching, the moves by Super,
yeah,
man.
Watching Super kind of juke in and out, it's like a shooting guard going into a center and breaking angle for days, and he gets a double damage. Nice. And that's going to free up Black a little bit on the bottom lane, because Arteezy, he's playing this Bristleback like a tempo controller, right? Imagine this is a puck. Like, he's just gank solo killing mid, ganking bottom, but he's doing it as a Bristle, which is just impressive in his own right.
He's being pressured fairly heavily, Black. He'll be forced back now, has the magic stick, Blink is available, and he's going to be forced to use it after this next cool spray. Arteezy continued to chase.
Yeah, I wonder why he's not using it like... just at the early, because he's just taking a lot of extra damage.
Exactly. It's a little unusual. Maybe expecting a teammate to TP in.
Look at Kuro just getting owned by a wolf up top.
That's another thing that we did not... I don't think the analyst panel had a chance to talk about.
Oh, no. That's the first thing that Winter
mentioned. Okay. I thought he mentioned the bounty hunter.
Yeah.
Yeah, the double invis Iron Shell shenanigans. Very irritating. There's a sentry ward here for the Dire, but there's actually no observer wards. They don't even know FY's coming, and... End of the day, Secret have a lot of squishy backliners. The Puck, the Rubick, the Chen. These heroes can easily be punished by Ion Shell. They're tankier heroes, not so much. Coil top lane onto Ice, trying to focus him down, but Vacuum actually, I believe, whiffing. Doesn't matter. Still get the kill with the Ion Shell creep. Man, Secret, as the analyst panel discussed, they don't have good late game. To be honest, it's With a really fat Bristol, I'd say it's okay. It's definitely not great. Arteezy's having a good time, but Puppy is level 3 at 7.5 minutes. I would say on average now, he's anywhere between level 6 and 8, depending on how much he's pressuring mid.
Top lane here, Wolves harassing a Karuki. He lost half his health. And here comes FY, the surge forward, Janata plus Orb of Venom. There's a lift and toss back. Nice toss here, but I'm not sure whether that's enough. Nice vacuum backwards. That's a level 1
vacuum. S4 doesn't have coil, unfortunately. There's a stick charge for Ice. He'll have the Soul Ring soon. He could surge out now. And he will do so. S4 trying to pursue. Zai does pop the dust. They knew FY was probably waiting to cancel any sort of initiation there. And he will pay with his life. But they get their Darkseer out safely. A nice counter kill for Secret.
Oh my god, these wolves.
This harassment is just unreal. He tries to finish up by Ice. He can't do it, though. That Darkseer, too much armor. Juki out through the tree line. It's probably cost him his life. Call again. No, he cancels the call this time. He's being very patient with his eye, but if he doesn't get these wolves, S4's going to go down as well. Finally, the call comes out. S4 almost dead. The coil up in 8 seconds.
The wolves!
They're just destroying S4. Can they dunk the wolves?
Oh my god, super as well.
He will get the kill, but it ends up costing him his life.
What a smart play from Zai.
That dunk.
Yeah, normally players are like, oh, I can only dunk heroes. No, you can dunk creeps too. Oh, he's going to get this boot jacked? You know how to actually steal boots from people that are standing and doing that, or runes, right? You scroll your mouse button up, so your hero like angles down, and you can actually click between hero's legs. It's really next level.
You're up against the bounty hunter. Honestly, you really can't afford to be dropping them in the woods.
I think that's exactly what FY is waiting for. Like, can I actually snipe?
A lesson that you learn at some point in a pub game. At some point, you play against that offlane Riki or the support or offlane bounty hunter. And
I actually got my boots stolen twice in a game. It was literally.
Well, that's how you learn, Lumi.
The saddest game ever.
So I can clear these stacks without dropping into the critical threshold. Fenrir is going to smoke, though. They have Finger of Death. Haste Rune picked up. Does Dire team a vision of this ward? They don't. Oh, this is a big kill. Zai, battle hungry in the creep. If he does stick around a bit longer, no, he'll back off.
I wonder if pros would one day learn how much experience each creep gives you. So if you kill a creep and you see that you only get half of it, you know bounties nearby.
There's so much else to think about, right? Courier is being hunted right now.
Oh no, Arteezy getting ganked from all sides here. Finger being dropped out, Impale to follow things up, and the Iron Wolf crew. That's a four-man gank if you count the Iron Shell right here. And Black's in here.
And that's the most farm here on the team. By the way, they're going to have track fairly soon. This bounty hunter is about to hit level 5. Roaming and supporting. He's even with the Chen. That is so bad for Secret. I mean, the one thing is, like, you, as going back to your point about experience, it's something you can tell early on. Like, if your first camp or two is being leeched, you generally know. But later on in the game, you have to actually look at the numbers, which that's where it's just a lot of other things you have to worry about.
Immediate D ward. Actually, that Sentry ward's been there a while. They're expecting Bounty Hunter to rotate behind the T1 and T2. Immediate smoke as well.
Oh, bottom tower being pressured here by S4. Deny going the way of Black. And he's already used the phase shift, so might be able to turn this one around. He gets silence, has 10 stick charges. No more Blink, though. S4 now Black in a bit of danger. He needs to buy a TP quickly.
He could blink the trees.
They have the puck to chase him, though. I think Black may go down here.
Oh,
but he could waste their time if he blinks right.
He needs to
Can he blink past them all? He will! Out of roam! Oh no! They steal the blink. They're gonna get the lift. But they're just gonna split push now. Looks like they'll try to take the tower mid with
Curl! I'm not sure if you watched it. He stole the blink, lifted back into a Trow net and a centaur stomp.
I think that's fine for VG Gaming though. They're taking the tier 1 mid on the back of this.
And tier 1 top.
And they force out the coil as well. It's not good for your crop to die, but the trade is definitely there for VG Gaming. Now if they lose FY, maybe not so much.
FY.
They have more sentries for him. Wolves are here though. Blink lift again. This free blink dagger for Kuroki making the difference. They make it a secondary kill.
Huge kill.
They will do so.
Yeah. But again, top being pressured, mid being pressured.
Well, I mean, I was gonna say it's a rough game for Kuroki to try and get some farm with all the pressure he's under, but hey, he doesn't need to farm a blink Lumi. He's been given a free one.
Yeah.
Actually, a bit better. So there's nothing that can cancel it.
Yeah, I still think that Kuro is probably one of the best Rubick players in the world, although
He's on the top 3 to 5, for sure.
I mean, FY is also there.
Rubick's also just one of those heroes that, like, so many of the top support players, it's like their go-to flashy hero. You look at, like, players like Aloha Dance, Soniko coming out of CIS, of course, FY. We've seen MMY's Rubick be sensational in the past.
March's Rubick.
Kuroki's, I think, is just the most... It's the one with the biggest track record. He's got the most professional games played on the hero. He's done a lot of work in the past. S4 getting caught top lane. As they try to TP to defend this tower, he has the coil. is maybe going to go down. Super needs one more auto attack. He can't get it off. Has to stay out of tower rage. Isosa is coming in, and he gets dunked. They might lose. Might lose more.
He calls the wolf, and the wolf just dies. Your Isosa. Well, there's no mini stun on that dunk. I'm just saying.
Secret are really outplaying Vici Gaming in these small scale skirmishes.
Yeah, I think they're really kind of overextending based on their previous snowballing. Can't really give Secret too many kills, especially off the back of that Roshan. Something that we haven't talked about, but that's a good half level for all of these heroes.
At end of the day, they did pick a Lycan against an Axe. If the Lycan gets caught by the Secret lineup, they have so much lockdown from Blink Call, your Coil from the S4 Puck, who is closing in on a Blink Dagger. This could be problematic for VG. They have a great split pushing lineup. They're going to get track gold on soon.
Yeah.
But they are a bit vulnerable to five-man Dota. You look at some of these heroes. Darkseer can be really good. He's level 9 already, still really wants to get to level 11, complete the mech. Lion does not excel in those situations, especially against the Chen, who also almost has his mech for Puppy. Just needs the recipe now. VG Gaming just have to be very careful about not giving up free kills, because a free kill this game leads to a tower.
Yeah, that could be a free kill here in front of a creep wave. Can he actually get dunked? Dust gonna get popped out. Track giving him a little bit extra movement speed, but I think he's gonna get burned down by that battle hunger.
Yep. Nice kill. Nemi on top lane. The wolves are marching in. They're looking for Arteezy. Fenrir starts with the impale. Wow, I don't think you go on that. He's got Aegis.
A very kind of a odd play from FY on the bottom. As a bounty hunter, your biggest goal is actually to disappear off the map, because when Secret sees a bounty farming on the bottom lane, they know that he's not in your jungle and ganking you. So, and getting caught like that is even kind of the worst part on top of that. So Zai kind of picking up some free kills for the team.
Remarkable poise from both of these teams. We saw it last game in game one, where Vici Gaming are down mega creeps, still managed to make all the right calls to come back. And Secret, after what looked like it could have been a train wreck of a laning stage, they buckle down a bit. They have sentry wards in the right place. Kuroki steals Blink, sets up the kills. They take the tower bottom. It was denied. Then they walk into Roshan. They are mounting a bit of a comeback here. Gold and experience. Gold still only slightly favoring Secret. Experience, though, they've got a nice 4k experience lead. And on the back of this X Blink, the Puck Blink about to come out, they might be able to snowball this a bit further.
Iron Shell breaking up the Blink here, but Ice is going to get caught. I feel like
they're getting caught out too much.
Yeah, they're being too cute. They're like, we want to set up more Ghost or Wolf and Iron Shell gank. Those are nice, but you... That's not your entire game plan, right? You gotta make sure that you're still taking towers and counter ganking and things like that. I felt like this game is not nearly as well played by Vici compared to the last.
It started off, it's the laning stage, that's the way to play it, right? Like, right. That chaotic tower diving, spread the map, constantly be a thorn in the Chen side, pressure the Rubick in lane. I feel like they played the laning stage perfectly, but
we're past that point.
Going for those plays now that the double Blink is out is much more risky.
Yes.
And Secret are also just doing a very good job of sticking together, anticipating Vici Gaming's movements. That said, though, Lumi, they're still pressuring a lot. And you see Black taking advantage of that. He's farming aggressively in the enemy woods. They're getting space in their own jungle for Super, who's now got 1,000 gold in the bank. They're giving up a kill or two too many, I would say, but they have Bounty Hunter. If they take those risks and they get a track kill, suddenly they'll be right back in it.
Yeah, that's definitely the silver lining. Although, if we look at item progression, like Zai's had this Blink Dagger on the offlane, who, by the way, got first blooded way before Queen of Pain has her first core item, which is the Orchid.
Uh-oh, Super.
Obviously, the Orchid costs much more, but, you know, as a safe lane quab, you should be getting this item right about now. So, I feel that Secret has reached their kind of core items much earlier, and they're definitely capitalizing on that.
They're making it go on Ice. He walks right into the entire Chen army. Ice, please! Wall's gonna get dropped. He'll be netted again as he will hold the surge, then stomped, completely chain stunned and locked down.
Can he actually get the kill? Oh.
Man, he was really far out there. Fenrir was back in the jungle. Super wasn't really there in position. FY's off on his own. He goes for the Shrew Kick, trying to kill.
Wolves.
Hand of God comes out. He tests the face. He nukes one. He steals the other. He still gives up the track kill, but it's only to a bounty hunter. And he's going to pay with his life.
Oh, maybe. They still see him, right?
Oh, maybe not.
Doesn't the Koi have that thing? That little wiggle thing?
Yeah, but he had no more AoE at that point. He already used Orb, Ult, and Waiting Rift, so...
Yeah, okay, so...
No way to kill him at that point.
This is where Vici's lineup is really on their weakest. How do you defend a push coming their way?
Well, it starts with the Darkseer, who still doesn't have his mech because he's died twice now. Ice normally the backbone of this team on the offlane, but repeated deaths costing them. I feel without the Darkseer level 11 and without the mech, they just can't do much against the five-man aggression. Chen now has his mech, and it does go back to something that Winter, or I forget who it was, someone from the Analyst Panel was talking about is that Bounty Hunter struggles quite a bit when teams start to group up.
Yeah. By the way, I think the play when this happens is you Iron Shell your Wolves, and you run it past the push, and you run it past to the next wave, and just kill it before it comes. But looks like he's trying to do something else with those Wolves.
They need to just finish the Dice mech. And just play a little more discipline, I think. When we see Vici Gaming have the most success, it's when they're setting up kills around the map with their supports. Fenrir is closing in on Blink Dagger. That's a really big item for them. And they have track hold. They should not feel like they're out of this game by any means. Map control, still decent for the Radiant side. They still have that tier 1 top. They still have their tier 2 in their own jungle. But another lost fight or two, and suddenly they lose Roshan control. Secret will be able to very easily take the Sekirosh. They're going to go for that smoke now.
There's a fight in the river here. S4 gets Orchid, and look at the burst damage.
That's a big kill.
Did he get the track off?
Yeah, he got the track off. It was either three or four heroes getting the track gold.
That's much gold.
1,300 gold swings. That's all they need to do, just to track kill here or there. VG Gaming will be right back at it. And if you're Secret, it's the opposite. You can't make any mistakes against the Bounty Hunter lineup.
Although you could argue that if VG makes a mistake, Secret could take towers very quickly, right?
Yes. It's Secret who can punish mistakes by taking towers, and it's Vici who can punish them by getting huge swings of gold momentum.
So, that begs the question, which side do you rather be on?
I feel like it just comes down to the timings. You know, does the Secret get their next core item on the Axe, the BKB? Bristleback's a decent sieger. I do feel Secret struggle a bit to actually break the base. Going high ground against the Darkseer, you have the potential to be giving away a big vacuum wall combo, followed up by the Queen of Pain ulti. And at that point, even if they don't die, their momentum will be completely just stopped at its tracks. So I think it's pretty close. It's just going to come down to the timing for these next big items. But end of the day, Vici Gaming angling for late game and Secret looking to end this one early, and it's just going to come down to execution. We saw Vici Gaming dominate in laning stage execution. It's been Secret heretofore dominating in the mid game, but end of the day, it's still a close one, Lumi. And I think given that it's close, I would give Vici Gaming the edge. But that can change very quickly.
Yeah, I mean, one thing that we haven't talked about too much, we've been talking about how Bounty Hunter has been very weak in terms of, you know, he doesn't do anything in a fight or push, but look at the way he's been playing right now. He's constantly behind enemy tier 2 towers, just constantly checking out things on items, maybe sniping a courier, maybe just tracking people. All of these are kind of things are that doesn't show up on the scoreboard, but it gives Vici Gaming a lot more information. For example, if he like catches out a smoke gank, getting a track on courier right now, like small things like that really benefits the way that Vici could play this.
Reminds me a lot of the way Cloud9 ran their Bounty Hunter TI. Yeah. Where the Bounty Hunter was purely a map control pick. Top lane, though, they're going to go in on black here. They get the chop. Nicely done by Zai. Coil was committed, and they don't take a tower. It looks like they'll vacuum S4, though. Now getting the Hex off. They might get the counter kill. Oh, that's not worth it if this turns around. He's alive for now, but that's a 3-hero track kill going against him. Now Zai spinning on the TP out, swinging that axe in a celebration. But 3-hero track kill, Quap for Puck. Quap is a bit more of a carry this game, but look at the gold swing, it's still 400 gold swing for Vici.
You'll take that track kill any day of the week.
That's the thing. You have to be very clean in your ganks.
Is he 11 yet, the bounty on her?
No, but he's on track for a pretty timely level 11. He's still even with both of the enemy supports.
Yeah. I mean, considering the fact that he's just been roaming around and not really farming too much, he's doing extremely well.
But yeah, this Bounty Hunter, it reminds me a lot of the Cloud9 one with the Meepo at TI4, where FY off the map constantly, you mentioned that's a big factor. Oh, he's going to find Arteezy here. I don't think they can kill him. They do a finger, maybe with the finger. Even then, it's really tough. They need a plus one. And they're bringing him in now. Black's blinking forward. This could be huge. Chen,
Lion.
They're coming into position, though. All of Secret are looking to back up Arteezy. I don't think they want to commit on this. And they will wisely back off. It might be too late. Blink call missing. Can they run down Fenrir, though? Track coming down to Zai. Dust now popped. In comes Super. Trying to turn this fight. Focusing on Zai, keeping him off the team. Now the Blink. The silence comes out, but the counter sounds from Black, preventing that coil as the Blink away from Black. He'll barely survive. Then they fingered on S4. Finger was stolen by Kuro. Can he turn this fight? Who's he going to focus it on? Nobody's low yet. He gets the zap on the Lycan, bringing him down. Now wall deploy, and a big quap ulti from Black, but he gets counter dunked. Gotta finish these heroes off. They get another track kill, and now Arteezy chasing. They'll then drop a sentry ward. Great presence of mind by Kuro as they zap down FY's Bounty Hunter. Oh my, what a topsy-turvy fight. 3-for-2. I think they got at least one, if not two, track kills there, so well, I'd still say a win for Secret.
Literally
though.
Every single Secret member was tracked. And he was really putting that 4 second cooldown of the new Bounty Hunter track like, to use.
200 gold win for Vici, but 800 experience for Secret. Very even.
Yeah. But Roshan is there, so Secret has a very, very good Rosh lineup, so they'll add that to their kind of bountiful win from that Rosh fight.
Wow, that's a late Vanguard. I guess he's going to be going for the completed Crimson Guard on this Darkseer.
Have you ever gone for the trifecta? Like just
Crimson Guard, Pike, mech?
On the same hero? It's just like, well, yeah, then I don't do anything.
Then
but,
you become public enemy number one.
But you're still very hard to bring down though, right?
That's true. Yeah, we don't really see those three items very often. The mech pretty common, the other two not so much, but if you're running the type of draft where you have all three, generally if you want one hero to farm it, it just takes too long. Because yeah. You're trying to hit timings, right? You're trying to end the game pretty early usually. Well, Lumi, who do you favor here? This is really close.
I feel by the way that Vici's playing, I think Secret's playing much better, so I favor them. But who knows? Like, if Vici wins a fight, you know, not only are they getting the track go, let's not forget that Lycan can mow down buildings very quickly as well.
That's true. A Secret, end of the day, it's only Bristle who's a hard pusher. With the kill stack.
Well, you could count Chen as a decent.
Yeah, army. I do feel like Vici are very good at killing the Chen army, though. Level 2 Quap ulti, they've got the
double Iron Shell, wolves, doing work.
The biggest thing with these wolves at this point is just canceling the Blink Dagger. Zai.
Look at that.
He just calls to try and kill off the wolves. They're not even gonna dust the freaking wolves! Oh my, that's a win.
Yeah. My gratitude. So, something that we saw in that previous jungle fight, not only did Bounty Hunter track all five heroes, which is perfect vision in a fight, you're also gaining a ton of movement speed, which I guess the Axe Calling Blade kind of counteracts, but it's just, again, a ton of small things that let you fight
you just
much
say,
better.
Did you say counteract?
Well, I mean, your haste hits, your... Okay.
Your I, just, I thought fast, it was funny, I thought it was funny.
They're hasted.
I got you, buddy. I got you. I'm just giving you a hard time. You mentioned a key level. It's the level 2 ultimate for the Bounty Hunter, and they have it now. This could be big. If Secret overextend at all, level 2 track is where it gets really scary. Doubling the amount of gold you get for every single ally. And the Bounty Hunter's gold isn't so important.
Okay, I'm watching Arteezy play the Bristleback, and he's literally tread swapping on every Quill Spray. And then going back to strength, that's how hardcore he is.
Isosai still only has the level 1 wall. This actually is not going to be that easy to defend.
How do they defend? How does Vici defend against the push?
They're not split pushing that quickly. Black is trying bottom lane, but you can't afford
Black
to give up lane breaks this early. Come back to the fold. Oh, the Chen creeps in position as Black will TP in. They look to go now. The Blink impale wildly up the mark. Now the counter call catches on two. Dunk is a bit early. The wall gets dropped. Everybody from Secret crashes into that wall. And now the Wolves onto Kroki in the back lines. But can they kill him off quickly? And if the mech keep him alive, Super will munch him down. Turning his attention to Puppy. He's got a back now. Arteezy still hanging on for dear life. He's damn tanky. Can they finally bring that Armadillo down? They will.
He's got Aegis.
But they have a Blink call now onto Super. They might need to use some buybacks here, Lumi. Oh, they cancel the Zai Blink! He ends up taking the Queen of Pain ulti to the face!
But it doesn't matter, they have breached the high ground.
Send back? Well, it's in time.
Yeah, they're gonna get at least one Rax, right? Or they're gonna go for it.
It's only a Bounty Hunter buyback. It's still a win here for Secret, for sure, but they do pop the Aegis, and they don't crack the base open. And, well, pretty big gold swing. They didn't get any track kills there, I don't think. 2,300 gold.
I don't think Kuro was tracked. You know, that's one thing they need to do in these screens, right? If you're affected by track, they should put it there. The end game score screen.
Yeah, I missed some of the old Dota 1 gold stats. What were the other ones? I think you could see, like, Devour gold even, or...
I'm not sure about that.
Yeah, I wish you could. Like, for Midas, for Devour.
Sure.
That would be a nice additional feature.
If you're going to add these graphs and...
Maybe not live in the game, but more so that you could see like afterwards with the endgame screenshot.
We want it now. Live.
We're the ADD generation, you know.
Yes.
Want that instant gratification.
So last game in this position, Zai have gone for a 4-staff. I feel like this game you want to be able to stand more in the front line. Yeah, he's going to go for Shivas. Because last game is much more about dancing around And this game, it's more about just taking
the push.
Oh,
he's actually going Abyssal. You mean Arteezy?
No, the Axe.
Oh, okay.
I was saying he got 4 staff last game, but this game, it looks like he's going to go more frontline with the plate mail.
Gotcha.
Which I think is ultimately the correct choice. Yeah.
Yeah, the Fichi gaming have a decent mix of magic and physical damage, but it's an item that kind of peaks at this stage. Good to help keep your team alive against the Lycan. It allows you to soak up additional damage from him as the frontliner. I think Fichi gaming don't want to fight too much right now against the Fiemen. End of the day, they're running a Bounty Hunter support, Lion support. These are heroes that excel in smaller scale clashes. Oh no, Fenrir, he'll be trapped out here. They managed to steal that Impale by Kuro, who now has a Blink Dagger, and they're going to hunt FY, latching onto it with Arteezy. Do they have any detection? Looks like none on any of these heroes. Even Puppy doesn't have it. Super immediately ulting bottom. He just wants to split push these lanes as quickly as possible.
I wonder if they would say that, hey man, his ult's on cooldown. It's a fairly long cooldown ultimate, but can't really push off of this because Vichy Gaming now taking the position that Secret took last game, just split pushing with their life depend on it.
I feel the Secret late game is a bit weaker than the Vichy Gaming late game is clearly stronger in theory, but Secret have that critical mass of items,
right?
Yeah.
Look at Arteezy.
They're going to just get in the base now. Racks are exposed. They'll start working on the Rage Racks here. There is backdoor protection, though. Just kind of checking. But bottom lane, the split push comes from Super. Can they crack through this base? They're going to start.
Where's the backdoor region?
No backdoor protection. There's no creeps in the base here, either.
Oh my god, Kuro blinking forward here. It's going to be a three-man call. One dunk's going to come through. Ice, in a lot of trouble. Has he used a mech? I'm not sure. Wall behind the Rax is doing a lot of work. Puppy, though, getting blown up.
Never got off the hand of God. Could be trouble as Arteezy tries to retreat. Remember, he doesn't have the Aegis any longer, but the Axe comes in. Great counter-initiation. Dunking another. Gets the triple kill. Zai. I think they may be too low to stick around, though. The tracks are out on everybody. Are there any buybacks for the Radiant squad? They have it on Lion and Lycan, but and Lycan even has ulti, so maybe considers it, but against the Axe, it's just so hard for him to go in. And we are seeing that the Lycan pick, as much as they did fine in the laning stage, he really struggles to get anything done in these clashes against an Axe. You have a BKB? Doesn't matter. Blink call, out of commission.
I think a large part of that is also the Bounty Hunter. Like, you don't actually do any damage, but looks like they're nice two-man impale. They're going to focus on S4, but he's very tanky. Urn is trying to drain him down, looking for FY. Sonic Wave just for a single solo kill. Looks like they actually clip Kuroki there as well. Arteezy trying to run away, being slowed down. Axe calling the Wolf low, but they see S4 on the left side here. No track being really given down. Only one here on Zai. Blink forward here by Fenrir, catching out Zai, but he's very, very tanky. Zai pops a BKB super. It's going to get spun down.
They're not done yet. Working on Zai. He'll get the Blink forward. Wow. He focuses on Black Secret, just running over Vichy Gaming to game 2. Can they get at least one track kill? They end the Axe mega kill. They get a track kill as well. They might kill off Arteezy too. This is going to be a lot of gold if he ends up going down. He's being sent back, I believe, by the Chen. No, just retreating out for now. And Puppy, S4, now on the way out. S4 trying to retreat. He will kill Fenrir as he jumps back. FY still chasing, but he can't go into this Axe. Blinking, calling again, catches out Ice. He's going to get dunked as well. It's 4 more dead, and Vichy Gaming just throw in the towel. A magnificent laning stage, but there was just nothing to back it up here in the mid game. And Zai, a cherry on top with that final dunk.
Yeah, I felt that mid game loose play, if you want to call that, from Vichy Gaming really kind of just threw the game away. They executed extremely well in the early game. But you kind of have to follow through, because if you give the Chen time, the push timing, and Arteezy apparently playing a Queen of Pain style on the Bristleback, just ganking multiple lanes,